Like, this feels so good. It feels so good. And I really do look like Batman. I look like Batman and Robin. You have to use your best assets. I don't mean physically, okay? Not like
Then dip me underway. You can kill me on my first love, but I went slow. Hold me till I scream for air to breathe. And wash me over until my will runs dry. Send all your sins all over me, baby, baby, baby.
What's up, guys, and happy Friday. I hope you all are having a great one. So I'm a little bit more judged up today. Got the hair poofy, some extra poofness and hair in here because I had the opportunity to do a reading for a children's hospital, and the program is called Reading with Royalty. I'm a little bit judged up, but you know, why dress down? If I'm already filming, I might as well just stay, you know, the way I am. Halloween is getting closer. Exactly tomorrow is Halloween, and I'm very, very excited. Obviously, it may not be that great because obviously we are in a position where we really can't do much trick-or-treating. So I still plan to decorate. If anything, people might be out of their houses walking around, you know, just to kind of see what the neighborhood looks like. So I want to at least make sure to put a smile on some kids' faces by at least dressing up the house. So we'll make sure to do that, and I'll show you how all that came out. And now it's time for a little segment I'd like to call Product of the Day. Product of the Day is brought to you by Clean Logic. It is a good heat and cool face mask. Now, I have went to Walgreens, I've been to certain places and tried all these little beaded things and all these things. I don't know if anybody out there has allergy issues or, you know, maybe sinus issues or pressure. Like, on y'all, it is the worst, unbelievably worst pain when you get off of work or something and you just feel that pressure right here. And it seems like right when it gets cold, because I'm getting older, maybe that's the problem, I'm not sure. But when it gets colder outside, some reason just pressure here just starts to flare and it's the worst. Then on top of that, because of the pressure, I get puffy eyes, and that's even more annoying. So Clean Logic has come out with a product, a heat and cool face mask you put on your face that helps kind of reduce the puffiness and reduce any type of sinus pressure. So let's go ahead and get into it. Okay, so this is what it looks like. Kind of like Batman and Robin. This is what it reminds me of, is this is definitely like a Batman Robin mask. If it was black, it'd be Catwoman. You know, I've seen them with the beads in them and stuff. I just feel like that don't stay. It doesn't really, it's not even pressured. The beads to me don't seem even pressured. You can heat them, but then you have certain patches where it might be cold and not as great, you know? Or you cool it down and then there's still little patches here and there. But because this is a gelled formula in here, it's even all the way across. There is no patches where it's too thick or anything like that. And on top of that, it's not going to freeze. So when you put it in the freezer, it gets cold. It's not gonna become a block of ice that you just stick into your face. So this is a gel formula where it does heat up and it does cool, but it's not going to burn you and it's certainly not going to become an ice block. So you put it in the freezer for about 10 to 15 minutes and it'll get super cold, or you can put it in hot water. Do not put this in the microwave, okay? We ain't trying to explode. In some hot water for about 10 to 15 minutes and then take it out, let it cool, and then you just press it on your face. You know, we do not promote any products without trying it out first. I'm gonna put on Cat Women. And this is kind of cool looking. It's actually really neat. Look at me. Look at me. Okay. Ooh, it always feels so. Okay, so right now what I've used is the cooling method. And it feels so, like, seriously, because of the California fires and because of the weather's been like hot, cold, windy. It's been a mess out here in California. Like, the pollen is just in the air floating everywhere. There's just stuff, dust, all kinds of mess out there. And I have really bad allergies, and it just causes me to have some headaches out this world. But I'm telling you right now, like, I can already feel the difference here. Like, this feels so good. It feels so good. And that's what I was telling you guys. So because of the gel, I really do look like Batman. I look like Batman and Robin. On my eyelid, just like Catwoman. So the cool thing about this is you can maneuver the gel where you want. So if you feel like it's not enough, even if it's hot or cold, you can push it in certain directions. I don't know if y'all can see that, but I'm pushing it here. If it's not enough pressure here, then you can push the gel here, whether it's hot or cold. That's the awesome thing about this. Like, the gel can go wherever you want it to go. Can you imagine just sitting at home, chilling and relaxing? Get you a glass of wine. If you don't drink wine, get some cranberry juice and just sip and sit. Sip and sit and relax. That's literally what it feels like. You can just sit there and just rejuvenate. Just sit here and rejuvenate. But I like this. I like this mask. Clean Logic, y'all did amazing. I love the gel in here. It's like, it's literally perfect. So you leave this on for about 15 minutes, luxuriate and relax, and before you know it, the puffiness is gone in your eyes, your sinus pressure is relieved, you don't have the migraine or headache anymore. It's perfect for that kind of stuff. So if you would like to try this product out or purchase it, you can get it on my Amazon store. I paid literally, guys, not kidding, $4.99. Or at amazon.com/shop/AndreaMcClue. So today's topic, we're basically talking about building your brand, building your own company, or building your own business, regardless of what that may be. So a lot of people have asked me, I've gotten a lot of messages lately about how I got started with doing the lip line. So honestly, it was something that I have been working on for months now, almost close to a year. We've been in the works and talking about it. It was an idea that we came up with. And I know that there's brands out there, you know, you have other products and cosmetics, and that's great. I think that's great, but that is really something that I wanted to put my own spin on it. I wanted my own name on it. I wanted my own design. Like, every little intricate detail was done by me and the vendor that I work with. So it was literally just an idea. I just wanted something for myself. I know because of COVID, maybe some people have decided to change their business plans and change ideas and things that they're doing with their life right now. And, you know, I thought, why not do things to build myself? You know, there's nothing wrong with deciding that you want to start your own business, regardless of what that may be. You have to use your best assets. I don't mean physically, okay? Not like that. But I mean literally in the mind, your talents. Whatever you feel that you are really good at. If you're really good at cooking, if you're really good at baking, if you're good at quilting, if you know that you are good at styling and clothing, just there's so many ways to do things that you can do for yourself. And it's something easy that you can do. It's not as hard as people would think it would be. And sometimes if you don't even really want to go that route and you do want to partner with a company, then that's great too. That is still, you are still building your own brand and building your own business. In this today's society, the way things are going, you know, we don't know how jobs in the market is going to be. And you have to either make the decision. It was like an epiphany for me. Let me just say that. Literally a year ago, I had this embedded in my brain that I'm like, why am I working my butt off to make other people rich? That is literally what I thought. I was like, why am I doing this to myself? Why am I working to make someone else rich when I could be doing it for myself? And sometimes it's just a matter of just an insecurity. For me, it really was an insecurity. I thought there's just no way that I can make that happen. I'm like, how am I gonna, I don't even know where to start. I'm not even sure what to do. But I did go to school for marketing. So I will say I went to college for marketing and for business. So I took what I learned from college classes and college courses in business and applied it to how I would want to market myself. Now, I've been doing that for years now. For the least the past 3 years, I have been learning how to market myself. I've had title holders. I get quite a few, surprisingly, of title holders that will DM me or email me and ask me, how are you doing this? How are you getting into the magazines? How are you, you know, literally all it is marketing. You have to brand yourself and market yourself. And if that means getting out there and talking to companies, you would be surprised. You would be surprised. Yes, have I had companies laugh at me? Have I had them, you know, I wouldn't say literally slam a door in my face, but I've absolutely had them just no. And that's fine. That is okay. It's okay to have, you know, companies say no, but there are companies that will say yes. And for those companies, you latch on to that and then you grow. And before you know it, you're gaining more exposure for yourself. And then the next thing you know, business just starts to pick up. And that is literally what has been happening for me. And so we turned it into something, or I should say I turned it into something, instead of it being something for fun. And I was like, okay, this is great. I was like, no, let's market this and promote it into a business. So I just decided a long time ago, I am tired of working a 9-to-5. I am tired of being stressed out all the time. And I just decided to work for myself and start marketing and promoting myself. So I encourage you, if there is an asset of yours mentally or a talent of yours that you know that you are great at, just go. It's so easy, guys. I know it sounds like it's something hard to do, but if it's a talent that you possess, that you know that you can just nail it and it's not a problem for you, then go for it. If you're good at public speaking, if you're good at coaching and mentoring people, that is your niche. You have to find your niche, and off that, you could sometimes potentially profit off your niche, off your talent. That is it for today's show. I hope you all had a great time. Remember, never be afraid to believe and market yourself. Great Halloween, whether you're trick-or-treating or not. Sit at home, relax, eat some candy apples, eat some candy, relax, and watch some scary movies, and enjoy your family. I will see you all next week. Bye.